afternoon. We're glad you're with us. Please stand. We're going to worship the Lord together. Joined us this afternoon as we enter into God's presence. You know, it's been a strange 2 years, hasn't it? Right? And now, as we're talking about, as Pastor has been preaching on, now's the time. I'm glad that we're gathered here together to give him glory. You know, he's been faithful to us as a church body through these 2 years, and he deserves all the glory for the way he continues to work here at Living Faith. He alone provides victory over the enemy, so we're going to give him glory today. Let's continue to worship him together.
Thank you.
holy ground. So I just wanted to say, I love that you're all standing and worshiping. If you feel like at any point you need to sit, that's fine. We're all just going to gather together and worship, okay? So the expectation isn't that you have to stand the whole time. I love that we're all standing, hands raised, worshiping, but I just wanted to free you up from that. If you feel like you need to sit, you can do that too at any point, all right? We're so glad that you're here worshiping with us today, because it just feels like it's time for us to take a giant leap forward as the body of Christ, right? And it's time to go out and find out what he's called each of us one to, and to serve him, right? We've been in this holding pattern for so long that it's time to now step forward and follow his will for us, right? So let's worship that. Let's declare that together. We're going to follow him.
Thank you.
Yes, his name is beautiful, it is powerful. It is the name by which we are saved. This next song we played already this morning, but we're going to play it again because it is a cry out for God to use us as he builds his church, as he builds his body. It's a cry out to be more like him and to lay ourselves down at his feet. So let's continue to worship him together.
Create me a heart that's clean.
as Pastor Ed said something this morning about us being the body of Christ, and that we are his body because we declare that he is Lord, that he is the way, that he is the truth, that he is the life. Amen? That is why we're here gathered. That's why we're giving him glory and we're worshiping him. We're going to continue to worship him now and that. Through every battle, through every heartbreak, through every circumstance, I believe that you are my fortress. You are my portion. You are my hiding place. I believe you are. Something else Pastor Ed talked about this morning was the pruning that's happened in the body of Christ over the last 2 years, the pruning that's happened in us individually as part of his body, right? And it's not always comfortable. We know that. But it's necessary, as Pastor Ed said, for us to grow, for us to grow in him, for us to continue to serve him, right? One thing that's so important about why we gather as he said, each of us is being pruned to play our own part in the role in the body of Christ. You know, in a football game, everybody huddles up, right? To run the play, you huddle up. It's not just haphazard, right? We huddle up, and then they run the play. But if you notice, everyone plays a role in that play, right? There's some guys blocking, the quarterback's making a pass, the running back's running, right? Whatever it is, everybody's playing their role in that play. Something else about that. They don't huddle up and then run to the sideline, right? They huddle up just like we gather. We worship, we hear the word, and then we go out and we serve him. But he's pruning us and preparing us to do that. Let's continue to worship in that.
Bring new wine out of me.
That is our prayer. That we continue to mold us, and then that he would use us. Because now is the time. There's no time like today to go out and to serve him, to go out into the world and reach people in his name, to reach across the aisle and show people that you love him as Christ loves him. He's calling us to build his church as his people, as his body. Let's worship.
Your church and the gates of
5, verses 1 to 11. One day as Jesus was standing by the lake of Gennesaret, which is the Sea of Galilee, the people were crowding around him and listening to the word of God. He saw at the water's edge two boats left there by the fishermen who were washing their nets. He got into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, and asked him to put out a little from shore. Then he sat down and taught the people from the boat. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and let down the nets for a catch." Simon answered, "Master, we've worked hard all night and haven't caught anything, but because you say so, I will let down the nets." When they had done so, they caught such a large number of fish that their nets began to break. So they signaled their partners in the other boat to come and help them, and they came and filled both boats so full that they began to sink. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at Jesus' knees and said, "Go away from me, Lord. I am a sinful man." For he and all his companions were astonished at the catch of fish they had taken. And so were James and John, the sons of Zebedee, Simon's partners. Then Jesus said to Simon, "Don't be afraid. From now on, you will fish for people." So they pulled their boats up on shore, left everything, and followed him. Back in 2018, I was looking for a new job. I was working, had a good job at a big major corporation, but I was working an insane amount of hours, and my little guy was getting older, and I said, this is not gonna work, it's not sustainable. And I was looking for a new job, and every time I'd interview someplace, the recruiters would go, "It's a shoe-in, they loved you, it's a perfect fit, they're really excited." And then something would happen where it would never work out. Sometimes the recruiter would say, "I don't understand, they said they're not gonna hire anybody and they're gonna completely restructure the department." I'd go, "What is going on?" And then some friends and some people said, "Maybe, is God just calling you to leave your job?" And I said, "I hope not. I have a family, I have bills to pay," right? You know, during that time, Jay loves to tell a story. Jay, if you know Jay on our tech team, that he knew I was looking for a job, and he said, "Well, if you could do anything, what would you do?" And I said, "Well, my passion is to lead worship." And he always laughs now. He says, "Well," his first thought was, "Well, that's ridiculous." Because, you know, Pastor Jonathan was here, and right? Like, okay, good luck with that, right? And a lot of people prayed. My wife and I prayed, and I went to work to go resign from my job, step out in faith in Christ. And I went, and my wife waited all day for the call that said, "Hey," I handed in my letter of resignation, and I got home. She said, "What happened?" I said, "Oh, I chickened out. This is crazy," right? And the next day I went and prayed. There was this little deli in the office, and I got out of a meeting 15 minutes early, which never happened. So rather than go back to my desk, I went down into the deli. And I found a little corner and got a cup of coffee, and I prayed. I said, "Okay, God, I know this is what you want me to do. I need your help a little bit. Kick me out the door if you could. I'm ready, I'm willing to do it, but I just need your help and your strength." Went back up to my desk, and literally within 2 or 3 minutes of me praying that prayer, something happened that made me say, "Okay, God," right? You know when Pastor Ed's speaking, but God's really speaking, and you're going, "Okay, God, I get it," right? I heard directly from him. As soon as that was done with that, I went and handed him my letter of resignation, not knowing what I would do. A couple months later, it turns out Pastor Jonathan was ready to move on and be a senior pastor at a church, and they needed somebody to lead worship here at Living Faith. I didn't know that was God's plan, right? But let me pull back up what I read for a second. What's Simon's first response? "Go away from me, Lord." He's in the presence of Jesus Christ. He's not going, "Wherever you need me, I'm going." His first response was to run. "Go away from me, Lord. I am a sinful man." None of us feel like we could do it, like we're worthy. He shouldn't use us. We know he shouldn't use us, but he's pruning each and every one of you, each and every one of us, to go and to serve him in the way that he's prepared. right? Even though our first response is that it can't be me. And that might not mean that he's calling you into full-time ministry. I understand that, right? But God's preparing something for you in your life to serve him. Whether it's to go into your job and to speak life into somebody, it's to show God's love to someone that may have never felt it. But the time is now. Because once they realized what they do, they didn't say, let me get my affairs in order. Let me go, I need to sell my fishing business first. No. They pulled their boats up on shore, left everything, and they followed him. God is calling each and every one of us to be his hands and feet, to build his church. The time is now. There's no better time than today. Let's stand up, and we're gonna worship in that again, because it's time for us to build his church, to go out, to reach people for Christ, to be the body, to be the hands and the feet. Are we ready to declare that?